Hey guys, welcome to my channel, The Daily Stuff, where I do reviews on random things that I personally use on a daily basis. If you're new here, please do consider subscribing. Right off the bat, as you can see, I went with a clean and minimalist look. And by completely going wireless, I was able to achieve that. No visual clutter, just the essentials. You might be wondering why I have my LG C7 OLED TV behind my setup. That's because of the limited space I have. As a result, I want to maximize every corner of the area by making it flexible and versatile. This serves as my work and play center. To protect the desk and establish a workspace, I chose Grovemade's wool felt desk pad in small and light gray. If you're not familiar with them, they originated from Portland, Oregon, and they are known for their great and thoughtful design paired with woodworking and fine craftsmanship. They offer an array of products that elevates the experience and enhances your working environment. Now back with the desk mat. It's mainly made of premium German merino wool with its logo stitched in premium vegetable tanned leather. The texture feels nice to touch and gives you peace of mind whenever you place any gadget, especially with mirrors or glass that can easily scratch. On the other hand, you do get little fibers here and there, but not to the point that it becomes annoying. In terms of durability, I'm not sure how it holds up over time, especially if you get accidental spillage from a cup of coffee or any type of liquid. Lastly, it's well priced at $45, plus they ship directly here in the Philippines, with just an additional fee of $8. Overall, I'm happy and satisfied with my purchase. As for my keyboard, I have the Keychron K2. A wireless mechanical keyboard which has the best combination of full-sized and 10 keyless keyboard. It has a classic look with just the right pop. I was already sold with aesthetics alone, but don't get fooled, it has a ton of features. It has 84 keys which makes it very compact and sleek despite being on the thick side of things. It includes a row of function keys which is a very welcome sight unlike Apple's Magic Keyboard. Connection is via wired Type-C cable or wireless with Bluetooth 5.1 up to 3 devices, switching between each one using the function key. It has 3 angles, the highest being at a 9-degree angle, ideal for typing for extended periods. Another great feature of this item and probably the best is compatibility. Regardless of the operating system, you can use this with either Mac or Windows. It comes with 3 specific keycaps for each, respectively. Battery life is great. It has 4000 mAh that can last up to 240 hours with the backlight off. Based on experience, it was even better. I was able to use this for 3 months with the backlight on and off for 2 to 4 hours a day on a single charge. For the lighting, I chose the white backlight option. It maintains a clean look that blends well with the whole theme. It has more than 15 types of lighting that you can play with to suit your mood, plus 4 levels of brightness. Now for the main reason on buying a mechanical keyboard, the typing experience. I chose the red switch option which is described as linear and quiet. This is the first time I bought a mechanical keyboard, so I don't know much about the specs, but I can definitely say I enjoyed my time using this one. It's very tactile and has a great feedback with no lag whatsoever. So far, I have 0 complaints and I highly recommend this product. To complete the mouse and keyboard combo, I went with the Magic Trackpad 2 instead of the traditional mouse, for the reason that it mimics all the hand gestures on the iPad, thus feels more natural to navigate. It has a built-in battery that can last a month or so. Unfortunately, recharging is via lightning port. It features an edge-to-edge glass surface area along with a lower profile which makes scrolling and swiping through your device more productive and comfortable than ever. It has 4 force sensors underneath the surface, enabling you to click anywhere, bringing functionality to a whole new level. This makes the iPad closer to a laptop or desktop experience. More importantly, less fingerprints. By the way, if you're interested with these items, links are in the description box below. To focus on work or just listen to some music, I chose the AirPods 2. The convenience of the Apple ecosystem finally caught up on me. The seamless connection is just amazing. It turns on automatically and is always connected by sensing when they're in your ears and pausing when you take them out. Battery life is average. We also tried this on Android phones and we had no issues as well. The downside, it is a universal fit, meaning comfort is a bit compromised, especially using it for longer periods. It's also not as secure, certainly not recommended for exercising. No noise cancelling feature. However, I have to say, this is the standard of wireless earphones. Moving on, if you want to make your iPad Pro your main computer, then this next accessory is a must. The HyperDrive 6-in-1 hub. Specifically made for the iPad Pro, you have everything you need from USB-A, USB-C, SD card, micro SD card, audio jack, and HDMI. I tried all the ports and it's all working well, and guess what, it comes in space gray. With full trackpad and keyboard support, there's only one thing missing to get the job done all day long, the iPad stand. This was probably the hardest to find. I spent countless hours on the internet looking for the right one. Most of the iPad stands available are below eye level. Luckily, I was able to find the Heckler iPad stand. It has a rigid steel construction with fine texture powder coat finish to resist scratches and fingerprints. It has adjustable resting pegs and sliding felt feet on the base for easy repositioning. It is compatible with all iPad devices with or without a case. It also supports portrait and landscape orientation, which is important since the front-facing camera of the iPad is on the side in landscape mode. Now you can avoid that awkward Zoom meetings. Lastly, the most crucial feature is the stable and ergonomic height. This prevents eye and neck strain, especially if you're working longer than usual. However, you only get one viewing angle, which I'm willing to have as a trade-off since this is my dedicated workspace. If I want to use my iPad as a tablet, I'll just easily remove it. This is a high-quality premium product. It comes in two colors, white and my favorite shade, as you can tell, black-gray. Now for the main attraction, the iPad Pro. I have here the stunning 12.9-inch model in space gray with 512 gigs of memory. I decided to choose the iPad Pro because I bought in with the idea of Apple's tagline, which is, "Your next computer is not a computer." I'm no tech guy, so I don't really get into the specifics or technical details. I just rely mostly on reviews and I'm still learning along the way. Having said that, I'm still convinced that this would be the future of computers. There's no better way of starting from scratch than having the iPad Pro as a computer replacement. I just love the versatility and capabilities it provides. Operating system is improving and continues to improve as we speak. Doesn't heat up like most laptops because apps are optimized. Very portable, especially if paired with the Magic Keyboard, which I'm still persuading myself of buying, especially now that restrictions caused by the pandemic are gradually easing up. The possibilities are endless, and I can't wait to discover the potential of this beauty of a machine. In short, I just love the iPad Pro as my daily driver. That sums up my iPad Pro desk setup. I hope you liked this video. If you have questions or comments, just let me know. Till next time, stay safe.